Please welcome, with a fascinating insight into his life and career, our celebrity guest speaker, Nicky Slater.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen.
This is good. I was expecting four people here and everybody else out on deck. And as you can see, I'm early for formal night. Because what normally happens is the
celebrity speaker
is on one evening twice in a smaller place than this. So being in the theatre is a joy. I've been asking them if I can use the different toys, and they've said, oh, we haven't got enough gas in the canisters to do that one. But we might be able to do a little bit of effects. We'll see. Got Steve on the lighting up there, and Richard on the sound, and Nicky's on the spotlight, and Kirsty backstage. I wanted to do flying. On the Ventura I did flying, but apparently Gareth went, oh no, sorry, can't do that, because the flying's behind the screen. I said, well, can't I just come through the screen as an opening? It would be good. And it's just the celebrity speaker talk, so now I have to be talking like this for the rest of the time. I'm going to take you on a journey. I was just being reminded it's a 45-minute journey, as we have somebody coming in directly after us. So I'll have to speak quickly. And this journey is taking us from the mid-50s on ice. And it's taking us on a journey through time, looking at ice dancing in particular. It starts off looking at the rivalry of couples, of judging in the background, of what goes on behind the scenes. And it brings us up to date to that celebrity show, Dancing on Ice. Now the gentlemen are cheering. They don't really know what it is, unless they're dragged to watch it because they want to go and watch the football. And as somebody so eloquently put it, a gentleman from Barnsley, on the last ship we were on, Nicky, I don't know who you are. And as my wife reminded me as I was wandering around the ship yesterday, you look like a tramp. Could you please look better? And I got spruced up last night. She says, you see, people recognise you now. But a lot of people have said, I know you, don't I? I know you. I always take it a bit lightly because I once had this thing after dinner. You know, it was a posh do, and at the end of it, this lady came up to me. I know you, don't I? I know you. I do. I know you. I'm thinking you do. You know me. I know you. And she went on, and oh, my ego was getting bigger and bigger. I know you yet. You're that jockey, aren't you? So with that, ladies and gentlemen, let's see if we can make this show move along. Here we are. Nice. And there were two marks. A big black mark, which was the most important one, and a little red mark, which was the increment out of 10. 5.7, 5.9, etc. If you were completing your dance career and you didn't like the judges that much, there was a possibility, because always when you're skating, you know that they're going to be judging you at the next competition, so it is good to actually be kind to them and smile at them, even if they have given you a 3.2. Thank you, very nice, yes. What exactly did you think I did wrong? Yes, you can't remember? Fine, thank you, that's great. Okay. But as they're all on the ice and all lined up, if there was one in particular at the end, as you were doing the run into the middle of the blues, and you just skated around and you just let your free leg slip a bit, you could take out judge number one. So there they are, they're skating. Now in old times you had to keep your hands down like that and everything was like that, because you weren't allowed to lift your hands above your head. Why not? Because they were trying to separate the idea, gosh I'm getting heckled already, of pair skating, which is where you throw the girl into the air and it's all free and you can skate a long way apart, to ice dancing, which was much more demure, like that. In an environment where my parents were coaches and coaching ice dance couples. So, as you would, they give you the opportunity of being in that environment. But you need a partner. So, here we are. Partners.
Two British couples, one after the other, have made this audience stand and applaud.
So thank you, Chris and Jane, for the warm-up. And I was actually thinking, you are an Olympian. You know how to win. You have your own mind, you have character, you've got injuries, you've decided you cannot do that, and you've taken an executive decision. I respect you in that. Here we go. Just 1 minute on tour, or 2 minutes on tour. The music can be a bit louder. We went on tour. I call it the Biggins, Bracken, and Bollywood tour, because Biggins was a judge, Kieran Bracken was a judge, and it was Bollywood. So, I'm going to take you to a moment in Manchester. And that man was there, Chris Fountain. He joined the party, he was skating. Another man had joined the party, and this is Ray Quinn, winner of Dancing on Ice the year before. So he joined the party. And so, there you are, Manchester Arena. This is what it looks like when it's being set up. And this is what was happening at the end of the show.
So, Dancing on Ice has been character building for me. I know what it's like to have a hairdryer effect from 10,000 people, or from 10 million people, booing, or whatever they do. And it's been a great journey, and it's been great to share a bit of it with you this afternoon. The other 20 minutes, we'll have to wait for another time, perhaps. But you've been a super audience, and for those of you that have managed to stay awake after a lovely lunch, it's been great to share time with you. Thank you for coming. Okay, that's it.